Hi, my name is Mandeep. I'm the founder of GMAT Mantra. In this video, I'll talk about one of the most common topics of GMAT sentence correction, that is verb ing, or we call it as the present participle. Now remember, present participle or verb ing has different usages in grammar. Now in GMAT, there are three usages that are commonly tested. First, as a verb. Second, as a modifier, and third, to show cause and effect relationship. So let's see how to identify when it is used as a verb and when it is a modifier. So first, as a verb. Now remember, whenever verb ing is preceded by any of the helping verbs, and when I talk about helping verbs, I'm talking about is, am, are, was, were, etc. So if verb ing is preceded by a helping verb, in that case verb ing is acting as a verb. So if you look at this example, John is reading a book. Now here reading is verb ing and it is preceded by is, which is a helping verb. So in this case reading is a verb. So this is the first usage of verb ing. So if it is preceded by some helping verb, it is a verb. Now, the second usage of verb ing, and that is as a modifier. So, as a modifier, it modifies the nearest noun. Now, there are two structures possible. One, we'll have noun followed by verb ing. In this case, verb ing will modify this noun, or it could be noun, comma, verb ing. In this case, verb ing will again modify noun. Let's look at the sentence. It says, John killed the snake sleeping in the sun. So here verb ing is modifying the nearest noun, and that is the snake. So sleeping in the sun is an extra information about the snake. Second, where you have noun comma verb ing, look at this example. The manager comma shouting loudly entered the room. Here shouting is again modifying the nearest noun, that is the manager. So in both the cases, verb ing is modifying the nearest noun. This is the second usage of verb ing. The third usage of verb ing is to show cause and effect relation. Now in cause and effect relation, there is a specific structure. So the structure is noun plus verb comma verb ing. In this case, first verb is the cause, and verb ing is the effect of that cause. So if you look at this sentence, the bomb blasted, comma, killing a child. So here we have a noun, bomb, verb is blasted, comma, verb ing is killing. You have to check, do we have cause and effect in this sentence? So here, how to check it? You ask whether blasted led to killing. So we can say because blast happened, therefore a child was killed, so blast led to killing. So we have cause and effect. First verb is the cause, killing is the effect. So these are the three usages of verb ing. Thank you.